don't care who's sitting next to you. Just worship Him. And He will not look far from you. He will turn His face towards you. Hallelujah. Let's read
Deep end.
Many of you are failing to witness to other people. Because you have never allowed the Holy Spirit in your life. Because Christ says, I'm going back, I'm going home. And when I arrive home, I will ask the Father to send the Holy Spirit. And when the Holy Spirit shall come upon you, you shall receive power. You shall be my witnesses in Montana.
Montana,
in Harankua, in Mamelodi, in Tshwane, the whole of Pretoria, the whole country, the whole continent, until to the end of the earth. He equips us to do the work. If you are not doing the work, it's like you are not recognizing the ability that God has given you. Don't think you can't make it. Don't think you can't testify to others. Don't think you can't invite people. You are able to do exploits by the power of the Holy Spirit. Allow God to fill you with His Spirit. Allow God to fill you with His fire. One day, John the Baptist said, I baptize you with water, baptize you with the Holy Spirit, and fire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Once you are baptized with the Holy Spirit, there is that fire that burns within you. The fire that won't allow you to sit and do nothing. It is the fire that causes you to run. It is the fire that causes you to share what you have. It is the fire that wants you to demonstrate the power of the Holy Spirit. If you hear me say
amen.
And God does not look at you like people look at you. I tell you, if I go to my place, they just see me as one of their kids. But God does not look at me like that. Others, when you go back to your place, they remember the wrong things you have done. But God does not look at you like that. He looks at you the way He has designed you. He looks at you the way He has designed you. He has designed you for a purpose. That's why He has deployed you these times. He did not deploy you long ago. He did not wait so that He can deploy you in future. He deployed you these times for a purpose. And He has equipped you with power so that you are able to do His work without failure. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When God anoints you, you become a different person. You don't remain the same. Hallelujah. That's why even when you look back in your life, you realize if God was not with you, you would have died on the way. But it is God who helped you to go through the desert. It is God who helped you to go through the water. It is God who has helped you to go through the fire. It is God who has helped you to go through the den of lions. You were thrown in the pit, you never died. Because God has a purpose with you. You were sold, but you are still alive. You were put in prison, but you are still alive. Because God has a purpose with you. If you hear me say
amen.
And if God be for us, who can be against us? No one can be against us. No sickness can be against us. No demon can be against us. No devil can be against us. No one can be against us. If God be for us, We can do exploits for the kingdom because we have the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit shall come upon you, you shall receive power. You become another man. One day Saul was looking for his father's donkeys. They could not find the donkeys. The helper said to him, "Let's go and see the prophet of God." And Saul said, "But we don't have anything to give him."
So we are not separate from Saul.
And his servant checked and said, "But I have something we will give him."
When
they arrived to Prophet Samuel, Prophet Samuel said, "The donkeys you are looking for, they are found. But your father is worried about you." Hallelujah. And the day he released them to go back home, he said to them, "You will meet a company of prophets. And the Spirit of the Lord shall come upon you. And you shall be another person." Because when the Spirit of God comes upon you, you become another person. God does not depend on your abilities. He just wants your availability. And he equips you to do the function. By the standards of people, I tell you, I don't qualify to be preaching the gospel of God. But by the standards of God, I am qualified. Because God qualifies the unqualified. This morning I want to declare and decree to you that never look on your weaknesses and think that God cannot use you. God can use stones. God can use donkeys. God can use murderers. God can use anything that you want. I tell you, Moses was a murderer. He killed two people before he ran away from Egypt. But when he was on that mountain, he encountered God and his life was changed. This morning I say to you, just open your life and allow yourself to encounter God, and your life will change. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You will never be the same. Paul, the man who wrote many books of the Bible, he was a serial killer. He was in
Judaism
before he joined Christianity. Now, when Christians were coming up in power, he thought it's a sect. He thought it's a fake thing. And he purposed in his heart that I will not allow these people to just drag the name of my God. I'm going to kill them. And he went out to the priests. He asked for permission. They gave him the license to kill people. He went from synagogue to synagogue, from house to house, looking for Christians. He killed them. But one day, as he was riding on the horse, he had an encounter with Jesus. I always imagine Jesus waiting for him. Here comes that murderer. I'm waiting for you. When he came before Christ, Jesus, he fell from that horse, and the voice came, "Soul, soul, soul, why umpuris?" Because when people are against you, they are not really against you. They are against the one who have sent you. Why do you persecute me?
Who
are you, Lord? He tried to open his eyes. Eyes were blind. And above all, Christ wanted to show him that you are nothing without me. He sent him to the house of a Gentile. So that the Gentile can lay hands on him and open his eyes. So go to a street called Straight. You'll find my son there. He'll tell you what to do. He did not eat for 3 days. A Gentile commanded his eyes to open. His eyes open. Now today I want to say to you, never look down upon yourself. For when the Spirit comes upon you, you become another person. You become a different person. A murderer called Moses. A stutterer, a stammerer, went to Egypt to liberate the nation of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Peter, the man who denied Christ, after the Holy Spirit came upon him, he was the first one to stand up. And the Bible says when he finished preaching, 3,000 people got saved. Never look down upon yourself. Just avail yourself. Because God does not really need your abilities. He needs your availability. Hallelujah. The man who denied Christ, when he walked on the streets, people will come out of their houses carrying their cripples, carrying blind people, carrying dumb and deaf people, carrying sick people, and they look at the sun and say, when he passes here, his shadow will be on this side. And they put their sick people where the shadow of Peter will pass. And when the shadow of Peter passed over there, my God. Peter did not mind what they were doing. He did not care what they were doing. He was minding his business.
Which means he was going to buy his quarter there.
But where his shadow fell, the power of God fell. The power of God fell. Because we are carriers of the power of God. Never look down upon yourself. You are a dynamite for the kingdom of God. When you lay your hands on this, when you command demons to go, those sick will rise. The demons will run away because of the power of the Holy Ghost. Never look down upon
yourself.
Don't even say, I can't share my testimony with you. Just begin to tell people what God has done for you. Be like that woman. Jesus said, go call your husband. She said, I don't have one. Jesus said, you are right. You have six. Even the one you have now is not yours. She put her packet down. She ran to the village and called everybody. Come and see the man who told me my secrets. He went to another street. Come and see the one who told me my secrets. He went to another, she went to another street. Come and see the one who told me my secrets. She went to another street. And then another street. And then another street. And people were running after her. They want to see the one who told her her secrets. She led them to Christ. And after Christ spoke to them, They said, woman, now we know. Now we believe. Not because you told us. Because we have heard. And because we have seen him. Our lives have changed. Your testimony has power to lead people to Jesus
Christ.
Come on, clap hands for Jesus. There was this man in the graveyard. He was naked. He was cutting himself with stone. The Bible says he was crying day and night. I don't know crying for what, but one thing we know is he was crying. Jesus took a boat. Crossed to his side, went through the bush to find only that man. When you read your Bible, it will say he's the man of Gadara. No one could put chains on him. No one could put clothes on him. And he had what we call a legion. A legion is about 3,000 demons. Jesus met the man of Gadara. And when that man saw Jesus, the demons started screaming, what do you have to do with us? Don't torture us. Tell us to go to the pigs. And Jesus said, you can go. Those demons ran to the pigs. The pigs ran to the ocean. And they died. Now when Jesus was walking back to the boat, the Bible said that man was clean and he was wearing clean clothes. I think somebody gave him clothes. And then he wanted to go with Jesus. Jesus said, don't follow me. Go to your family. Go to your friends. Tell them how much grace you have found from the Lord. And the Bible says the man of Gadara went to Decapolis. And when you check Decapolis, it means 10 cities. He went from Pietermaritzburg to Durban. From Durban, he went to Cape Town. He came to Johannesburg, Pretoria. He went to Mbombela. 10 cities! Guess what was his message? I was mad. But now I'm sober. You can be sober too. He went to Durban. I was mad. But now I'm sober. You can be sober too. Hallelujah. That is the power of the testimony. Don't be afraid of sharing your testimony. Don't be afraid to tell people that I was sick but I'm healed. I was a sinner but now I'm saved. And as you do that, you are leading people to Jesus. You don't need your power. You just need the Holy Spirit. Because when the Holy Spirit comes, you receive the power. You receive power. You receive power. That power, when you stand in front of demons and say, pack and go, they cannot withstand the power. When you stand in front of sick people and say, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command you, cancer, die. It has to die. Because of the power of the Holy Spirit. Never look down upon yourself. Allow God to work through you. If you hear me say amen. If you hear me say amen.
How good am I?
One day God calls Gideon. He says, you men of valor. Gideon looked at his situation.
Gideon
He looked at his circumstances. He said, me.
Are you not
men of valor?
When I was not here, I'm the
last born at home. Our tribe is the smallest. And we are all poor. Because God does not look at you the way you are now. He looks at you the way He has designed you. He did not design you to be poor. He did not design you to be small. You are great in God. You and the Holy Spirit are a dynamite. Come on, clap hands for Jesus. You and the Holy Spirit are a raging fire. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Be like Elijah. He said, it is long that we have been between the issues. We must choose today which God we are going to serve. Before we close, I want to give a chance to those that are not born again. I want to give you a chance to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. You don't have to feel anything. You just need to believe. The Bible says you believe in your heart and you say it with your mouth, then you will be born again. Now, this morning and this moment, I'm going to ask you to bow your head and pray.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, I have heard your word. I come to you to ask for forgiveness. I acknowledge that I'm a sinner. Please forgive me all my sins. Wash me with your blood. I want to be your child. I believe in my heart. I confess with my mouth that you died for me. I receive you as my Lord and Savior. Amen.
Now, after praying that prayer, you are born again. You don't have to feel anything. It's true, others will feel something. They will feel as if the weight that was on them is lifted up. But others don't feel anything. Because we walk by faith, you have to believe that you are now born again. Now I want you to be serious about it. Take it serious. Believe it. Study the word, pray, and come to church. Attend church. And our address is 760 Breed Street in Montana. Our church is called Grace Christian Fellowship. The address is 760 Breed Street in Montana. You are always welcome, you and your family. And if you want us to pray for you, just send us a message. We will pray for you. Send a message to prayers@gcfc.org.za. prayers@gcfc.org.za. And let us know if you have accepted Jesus Christ so that we can help you, we can assist you. And God will bless you. You will grow spiritually.
Thank you for being part of this service. May God bless you. We thank you for your offerings and also your support. Please send your offerings to Grace Christian Fellowship, APSA account 405-963-5298. That is Grace Christian Fellowship, APSA account 405-963-5298. Please use online banking and apps.